So how was this season for you after coming back?
It was a complex season. One amazing at the end. It is the best word that characterizes our season. Why the best? Why amazing? Because we went through a lot of difficulties, starting with the beginning. The team was not ready. We didn't have the full group. We had players that were used to play in a totally different way from the philosophy that we brought back to PAOK. And so for this reason, there was a time to adapt everybody, to adapt the group, to adapt our coaching staff to the players and to understand very well. The other difficulty it was that at the end of the period of transfer, we brought others free players. So again, we delayed everything. So we lost the first part of the autumn. And after coming, all what came is a lot of games, Thursday game, Sunday game, the programmation, it was for me unbelievable. Even the biggest enemy of us couldn't make so perfect to be very difficult. We had the problems with COVID, we had a lot of injury situations. We have ups and downs that made us crazy, really crazy. And it was not a balance in this situation. We played very nice games as we played bad games. When we played good games, we were flying. And after when we started the smallest difficulty, immediately we dropped everything, confidence, reactions, and we went for longer period in negative results, as happened between November and December. So from all of these points was a complex situation. We moved in next in 2022. We started to gain confidence. We started to fix the good and the organization and the philosophy, and we start to win. But having again a hard program, the COVID that came back to us made us to have a different schedule, and again to play every 3 days all the games after start the European competitions. And so again was a difficult program, but we managed to go until the break of March in a fantastic situation, having a big difference from the third position, qualifying in quarterfinal of Europe, passing AEK in 2 games in quarterfinal of the Cup. So after this break, again, we enter in the hard and difficult program because it was the playoff games combined with the cup games, the 2 games against Olympiacos, and combined as well with the 2 games against Marseille. Games that took from us all the energies and provoked us to push more than what a player could give in this situation. We were struck again by injuries, and we after the game against Olympiakos in Karaiskakis, the second leg in the semi-final, I was inside of coaching changing room, and came my assistant Chris, telling me the situation of the players, the injured players. And after he analyzed with Saki, the physio, with the doctor, We knew exactly also the period, how long it will be for all of them. It would be for all of them. And really, my answer to him was this. I don't want to think in this moment, because if I think in this moment, at this situation, I would not be able to enjoy the qualification in the final of the cup, because I understood how serious could be the problem.
At the beginning of the season, when you agreed to come back, you said that this team will win the league and go far in Europe. And at the middle of the season, when we started having difficulties, you said that you might create a lot of pressure to the players that they were not ready for it. When did you start thinking that maybe your approach in the beginning, or how you thought things would be, maybe would not be the case in the reality?
When I said the first statement that we would go to win the league, it was one provocation, because I knew what happened in the last 2 years here. I talked with persons that were around the club, with persons that were or are fans, but in a neutral way, of PAOK. And I talked a lot with the players. And everybody was passing me the message that they lived very bad years, losing the confidence, understanding that they cannot even go in a fight with hopes that could do something. And so it was a situation in which there were also a lot of changes from the group that I left in 2019. So players that came maybe without experience in winning, players that were not used with kind of pressure. So I tried through this statement to provoke everybody to go and fight against their limits, and to give this kind of motivation. I knew in the moment that I made this statement that could be also a risky situation, because in the first moment when something would be wrong, might the players, without having this experience, to start to lose their confidence, and this provocation to create other problems to them, and so to lose the balance. In fact, this was happened. I can tell you that this lack of balance, this two crazy situation from up to down during the same game, because we played very good periods of the game. In one moment, we do one, two mistakes, and we lose totally the confidence, giving possibility to opponents to come back. This was the first part, less in the second part, totally less. So this lack of balance came from this aspect. So in that moment, I had to intervene, to go straight to the point, to take the responsibility on my shoulders totally, and to tell that was a mistake to make this statement. But football is this. To build a team means also these situations, these kind of talks, these kind of provocations, steps back, steps in front, having strategy, attacking somehow the opponents, making steps back, feeling the group feeling the group, not feeling, making the group to feel something, and gaining step by step something step by step, game after game, moment after moment. I believe that also there were some players that entered in the team with freshness, in the perfect moment, giving to the team this technical balance that the team needed. And like this, we start to have very nice results, the results that give us the possibility to leave this end of the season with this pride that we can achieve one of the best seasons in the history of PAOK. Again, without having just nice moments. We had also very, very tough moments.
How do you find this balance?
The balance is nothing, is not something that you can find. The balance is something that you must build. You must build through a lot of things, through the atmosphere inside of the group, through atmosphere that is immediately around the team, through the technical part inside of the games, through trainings, through talks, through videos, analyzing your way of playing, your mistakes. Sometimes for players, these mistakes that you analyze could be very hard to be managed, correct. But they must do through this. They must go through this situation. Just like this, we can improve through understanding the situations, through not going so down when you lose a game, as we have to keep a balance in a correct way when we are very happy. Still, we have to learn in these situations. 1 year was not enough, but 1 year brought us a lot of experience. These European games were fantastic. They created to us a lot of problems, because at the end we played 16 more games than others under huge pressure, plus the 2 games of qualification against AEK and 2 games against Olympiacos, which are not easy games. One thing is to play against AEK 2 games and the opponent to play against one second division team, and you the next semi-final against Olympiacos, and the other to play against Lamia. It's totally huge difference about spending energies, about emotions. You must be at the highest of motivation, determination and emotions. And so are too many mental energies that you spend. The risk of injury become very high. And this happened combined with European games that were on the same way, because it was to be or not to be. So during this period, we faced teams that they enjoyed their time, they slept in their beds all the week, they prepared in a normal way the game, they had time and they had very, very risky possibility of having injury situations. And so this provoke us again to other mental energies that we had to spend.
Which do you consider the most difficult part of the season? The beginning, trying to pass your philosophy, your mentality and style of play, the period in late November, early December that we had the defeats, or now that the team, as you said, ran out of energy mentally and we had this all problems with injuries?
In my opinion, are three very difficult situations, but all of them are totally different. It was the beginning with the European Games of qualification, because there were a lot of hopes and it was a huge responsibility for me personally coming back, and people expecting this qualification, and we are not ready in summertime, we are not ready as a group, we are not ready for a lot of aspects. But and we faced especially Rijeka, which is a Croatian team with a good football, with a good quality of players, and this was the first difficult period, but this was more technical difficult period. The second period, which was the hardest one, was between middle of November and the middle of December, the period when we had the negative after Slovan Bratislava game. Yes, this. This was maybe the hardest, and also personally I was very disappointed. I might I'm not I might. I must admit that also me, I lost in that moment a little bit the confidence and really hard, but I knew that one qualification in the last game against Lincoln home would change everything for us. I knew this. And this happened. I had around me the people, my coaching staff, you people that which we work very close, and everybody try to give the best and to keep this limit of confidence for this period that would come.
How do you manage?
And the third period, it is this starting with the games of Marseille, going to Olympiacos, when we push and we lost half of the team and we had to play without half of the team. Our good situation came also because we managed to have 12 points in front of third position at not in playoffs, at break, when we had the break, because in playoffs we gained the first two games, so we increased the difference. And this is more or less the story of this year. But I believe that you keep going on the same Greek mentality to ask just about negativity. No. You should ask about positive things, about this optimism, about...
This is not asking me about negativity, you know, but you need, in order to
highlight the whole season,
you need to highlight the difficult moments, so the people from outside,
yes, but you have also
to understand what is happening inside the team.
Yes,
so next
I will
time
tell
you
know something.
Judge better.
It's the same psychology, mm-hmm. It's the same psychology as it is for a group of players. Because if I go and we analyze just the negative aspect, the players lose the confidence all the time. All the time in a analyzed situation, analyzed game, we start with what we have to improve, and we finish with the beautiful actions that we created. With the ball or without the ball, because this is
what we do here. As well.
So
we started from the negative.
Negative, and now you go.
Going
so
the
I wanted just to attack you one more time because you took my time. So
how do you personally manage this type of difficult situations? Because during November, you said at this period of time, you said that you were discouraged about what was happening. We know people doesn't know officially that you had a very difficult meeting after the game against Unicos with the players. So how was this period of time for you as in terms of management? In how did you think, how did you wanted to act in order to go out of this crisis?
Look, I forgot to tell you one aspect that maybe is one of the most important or one of the strongest point of our coaching staff and of myself is the possibility of working, is the possibility of training. Because we work in a very organized way and we work in details and we need always time to work. Having all this schedule, from one point of view, it was fantastic that we managed to qualify and we managed to have these results, this experience that increased a lot the confidence and the enthusiasm inside of the team. But on the other hand, we start to train in a normal conditions less and less and less and less, because we are forced to train just in groups, sometimes 10, sometimes 11, sometimes 12. The players that played one day before or 2 days before, they were in a process of recovering the energies or not together, and for this reason start to be very hard. So in that period, even if there were games in a row, we try to many thinking about the possibility of training and the moment when the break for the Christmas would come and we would have the possibility even for 10 days to be together and to work again for organization, for details, for videos, more and more. More about ourselves. This was one aspect, and it is that one that gave me the confidence that we can go out from this situation. The other aspect were these talks with some players. The other aspect was the situation of European game, knowing that even if the people didn't understand how important was our game in Slovan Bratislava, but really that one gave us permission, and I said immediately after the game, this is a result for qualification. And this story with Lincoln qualifying home push us to have a the talk about the players. We understood also how it is for every player, how can manage, how can be with us, which is the adaptation between them, between the players, because also this is important. And so were a lot of things, a lot of details, as always, that in a correct way of thinking gave me back this balance and overpass this situation of losing the confidence because of the negative results. At the end of the day, again, we are talking about balance. In life, as in football, as in life, I think that the persons and the people that find the balance, they are successful.
How many sleepless nights you had this period of time?
Don't ask me about this because really, I cannot tell you if I have 10 normal nights, but I don't believe because when you go like this, you sleep all the time. It's 3 o'clock. You go in every 4 days. You have to go in another bed. You have to come back in the night after the games. In the night you cannot sleep. It's the adrenaline that you play with the images of the game, the images for the next game. As a player, it is a little bit better because you can manage, if not immediately in the night of the game, but at least the next night. But for a coach, finish one game which was full of pressure, full of emotions, full of adrenalina, and the moment that finish that game, you have 1 hour, 2 hours just to calm down, because immediately come in front of you the image of the next game, and from here start, how we'll play, how we'll do, what I have to do, when I have time and how I will prepare the opponent, what I have to do in this one or two trainings that I have to bring a little bit the team for the game. So are so many emotions that it's impossible to sleep. And if you go 1-2 weeks like this, after it's finished. I hope that in this holiday to be able to have a normal rest, because also us we need. But on the other hand, what to tell you is this adrenalina that make myself to be with enthusiasm, with the pleasure of being in the pitch, this fighting spirit that make me to be a happy person.
And how is it to feel that almost everybody from the whole organization, meaning the football department and generally from the club, depend heavily on you and have this trust? There is the positive aspect, which is everybody trusts you, and there is the pressure that comes with this trust that everybody depends on you.
It's better not to ask me. It's better not to ask, because yes, it's hard. It's hard. It's very hard, I know. This is the situation, the hardest situation, when we have a negative result, and I know that I disappoint a lot of people, And because of this, I have huge pain in all my body, and I am not normal person for next 2-3 days. Depend also when it is the next game, but until the next game, I am not normal. Everything hurts me. Everything inside of me is pain. Everything. I can tell you that maybe in these moments, my only possibility of keeping the balance is my wife.
This would be the next question. What makes you feel more relaxed, and which person makes you have this balance? And what type of things do you want to do after a game in order to let your body and yourself go and not feel this pain?
No, this is after a negative result. After a positive result, I cannot tell you that my happiness is to go, to fly, to I don't know, to exteriorize, to put out this happiness. No, it's inside of me a deep feeling of relief that I did the correct job, let's say. I like after the game to have all the time one glass of wine, to have my people around me. And in fact, we have this habit that after every game and 2 days before the next game, we go for a dinner, and we drink one glass of wine, and we talk normal about our problems, about football, about Batina, let's say, more relaxed atmosphere than it is in the pitch. And there we have all the time a problem, because having a group of people, especially players, means every day to have at least one problem. This is another aspect of this job, and maybe it takes a lot of time, but somehow in one moment we have to talk also about them.
This is where have taken the personal side of the story. How is also Anna, your wife, handles this difficult job? Because you, as you said, you are on the move a lot, you have a lot of pressure, there are good moments, there are bad moments.
Well, first of all, I believe that I'm a boring person as a family person. With me, she cannot enjoy, as I am probably for my children as well. I don't know, maybe if I was alone now or divorced, I should have thought a lot of the possibility to trying to go in another family, because I would have destroyed for sure the other person. Anna at least was with me from beginning. She passed this period as a player. We went through very beautiful moments, through love on fire, through moments of war, tough experiences. So we learned to know each other, to understand each other, to respect each other. We are not just a couple that is a couple because of the love. We are a couple because we are much deeper inside than love. It's about respect, about understanding, about accepting, about managing when someone is upset, the other understand, and it's not anymore a fight. I don't know if we fought in the last 1 year. So I know about this. On the same time, I am lucky because she doesn't understand football. She doesn't understand anything. And I can tell you two stories that are very funny. One is from Al Hilal and one is from PAOK. one from Al Hilal was, we were in a game, in a league game, and she was in connection with my mother, which was in Bucharest. She was, and I was in Saudi, and we played the away game, and usually Al Hilal was with blue shirts, and at that game we played in the home of a team that used to play with blue, so we were in white shirts. And when I realized this personally, before to start the game, I thought immediately, oh, this will be a problem for my wife, which was in front of television. And in fact, until 75th minute of the game, she was sending messages and pictures and short videos to my mother with the team in blue attacking and saying that is Al Hilal. In 75 minutes had to enter Gomis, which was before the final of Champions League, and I kept Gomis to refresh a little bit out, and had to enter in this last 50 minutes, and she recognized him, which was in white, because she knew just Bafe, and in her mind, white, why Bafe is in white? Ah, probably when he went, he would enter in the pitch, he would take white down and he would put blue. and Bafe entered with white inside of the game, and she still didn't understand, but what happened? What is this? Why? And just after this, she started to have doubts that something was wrong at that moment. And finally, she discovered that that was like this. And another aspect was the semi-final, the second leg with the second leg. No, two I have to tell you about her here, because are the last. The second round in Karaiskakis, no? She was here with one lady that never saw one game, but because football means emotions, she started knowing us, being with us, start to have also her feelings for football. And they watched the game, and it was 1-0 for Olympiacos, and after we scored 1-1, it was a huge joy, happiness, they jumped, they did here, they hug each other. And after they calm down and they watch again TV, and was the replay of the goal. And again, they start to enjoy and to jump here because they believe that we scored the second goal. And the last game, again in Karaiskakis, she knew that we played against Olympiacos, and she tried to follow the game, and finally she discovered on channel PAO against Pasianina, but she saw PAO, she believed that it's PAOK, and she stayed to watch Panathinaikos and Pasianina. Ok, she didn't follow the game very, but she listened, she was doing something, and she listened, she understood why they speak about Panathinaikos, because it's the game of PAOK. And after 1-0, oh, I was so happy because Panathinaikos won the game against Pasia. And in one moment she understood that finally is another game totally. And she told me, but I know that if I told you this, you'd spread all over the world, and I don't want to tell you. Please tell me. And she told me. And I said, okay, I will not say it to anyone.
And you didn't say it to anyone.
But it's nice. Look, these are the moments that make me to relax. I have other experience, but this, okay, I'll keep for another time. Like this, if I had a wife that was also her with football and starting to believe that football, she knows football, and to start to give me direction after to come, oh, why you didn't do this, why this, why the other, I would have been destroyed, because there are a lot. I remember my grandmother, mother of my mother, that was very upset that my mother married a football player in her mentality in 65, which she was a teacher. It's not possible to marry a football player. Okay, why one engineer? She, my daughter should have had. And after, it's when she arrived 70 years and my father became a famous player and okay, she started to give direction to my father as well to me. For to leave from my house, pay attention, don't go too much out of the goal. So you understand also this situation. I am happy with my wife. She helped me a lot.
Which is the most critical person? So you said your wife doesn't give you advices. You are coming from a family that lives with football.
No one in family. Okay, my father, my mother, but my mother unfortunately now is start to be old, 78 years old, so is not anymore the same person. This for me is a sad aspect. But no one in my family is critic because no one follow in this moment very deep. My daughter is with her kids, her family, my son with his business. So, but I believe that it's a huge.
Do you see yourself?
It's a compensation. No, wait, wait, wait. Or you need that? I need other critics.
No.
Here around the people are born to criticize and especially to see negativity. Or what do you believe? That boss is an easy person to manage this situation? So, it is fair. From one side, nothing. From another side, here.
Leaving management aside, because we will discuss it, do you see yourself being in football until 70 years old as your father, or you will travel the world in 2-3 years, as you said some days ago?
Look, I know that I am a person, and you know very well, I came here, I put all my love in my job, in the team, in the place. Really, for me, Salonique is something that it's deep inside of me. And wherever I go, I must love. If I don't love, I cannot work. I cannot remain there. I must love the place. I must love the players. If I don't love the players, I cannot build up a group of mentality, a group of with which to go in the battles. Look, the last years with PAOK, we won 2 times the double. One time was this story with commissions not to go back, but they stole from us the title. This is the reality. But it was double. Next year we had another double. After we went to Hilal and we won Champions League title and cup. We came back here and we are final of the cup in this moment, so we win. Is a quarter final of Europe, second position, fighting, going until the end in all the competitions. This means to be able to have a strong mentality. And this strong mentality comes from all these kind of aspects, from these relations, from don't believe that a player is happy that doesn't play. They are very sad, very, and usually players all over the world are for their interest. But having such a kind of approach, you provoke a player to come toward you, toward the group, to leave a little bit from his selfishness and to give more for the group. When a player does this, the chance for the possibilities for a group to be a successful group increase. And this happens. So I love a lot Salonique. I went from here because really I was very sad in one moment. I came back again with joy because I love Salonique. It's not a strategical movement. And you know very well, all the people that I know, they told me, don't go, why you go back? You are crazy. You are crazy. I said, no, what? I don't have a strategy for this point, from this point of view. And I'm not afraid about anything. In any case, I made here fantastic job. I am in the history of PAOK and I will remain. Nothing could change. Nothing could change this. Even if I had a very bad period now, nothing could change. So I come because I love this place. And like this, I can tell you that in this moment I dream and I would like in 2-3 years to have the PAOK. She doesn't have a normal life, as I don't have normal life, and to enjoy this life. I don't want to be my father. I never made comparison with my father. I never project my future as it is, it has been my father's career. I enjoy the trophies that I won. I am 53 years. I made a lot of good things, a lot of trophies, a lot of good job. So what I had to show to myself, I already did it. So I love my job, but also I'm thinking very serious in 2-3 years, 4 years to stop. Now, this I'm thinking in this moment. Maybe in 2-3 years I could change life, you know very well, that put you in a very, very strange and very different, totally different situations and make you to change your opinion.
Being a good coach is one part of the job. Being a good manager and handling personalities is a different part of the job. I'm speaking for myself, working 22 years in football now. You are the person that has the highest skills and talent in managing difficult situations and personalities. How is it from your perspective? How do you see this connection with the players, the management, satisfying players that they don't play, making them fight for the team? And this is also something that players say, that you are a very clever person that knows how to manage situations and put out the negative feelings, put out all the pressure and let them play and show their abilities.
Really, I don't know how to explain. I'm like this. Probably the first feeling that they start to have is that I love somehow them. I go toward them with emotions. I believe that is this, because what I told you before, that I need to love place, players, people. I like to have around me enthusiasm and people that don't talk about the other on the back, that are there together and they enjoy. Not I respect them, everybody. I respect Morpheus, I respect Kyriakos, as I respect Chris Pandelis or Maki or Maria or whoever you want. On the same way, they are there for their job. They know very well what to do and they must do as they want. I don't interfere in their job because they are better than me in this. So also with players is this kind of respect. I try to give the feeling to everybody that is important. Never in the training I take just a part that players that probably would play. After, during the season, they understand that to everybody, yes, it's true, some they play more, some less, but everybody play, everybody has to be there involved. Everybody has this feeling of being respected by their coach. Okay, and after is also the way of how a person it is, how he feels to manage. My strong point that could be also a weak point, but this is regarding myself, is that I go very, very deep inside of the problem, analyzing, and I try to understand very well why a player behaved like this, which situation, what kind of problem or what kind of Yes, problem made him to react in one way. There are, you reacted like this, go out, or it's finished, or no. And I understand the player, and after I try to manage, I don't go to fight with him. I try after to explain that it was wrong what he did, why it was wrong, and step by step calm down. And a lot of times I found out that behind the reaction are things that you never could have believed that affect the work of a team. Things from outside, in families, stories, around, a lot of things. And in the first moment, why he did? Because he's arrogant. Why? Because he doesn't play. Or because, no. So this is probably another point that helped me to have good connection. And in the last, but probably not the last as importance, is the fact that I am correct with the player, straight, but in a very kind way. I try to make him to understand very correct the situation, on the same time making him not to feel bad, or that he's not good, or that I don't know how.
And what does your staff mean for you?
My staff?
Yes.
A lot. Without good staff, it's impossible to be happy personally, to have results, to improve. Okay, also with staff, we build up a relation, and step by step, we gain confidence, I gain confidence, they gain confidence. It's like in every group that has to be built up. But it's about how they prepare parts of the organization, about the management. I have to trust them, and we all together we work. Sometimes I don't go to players because it's not necessary. Are the assistants, the people around me, that they have 2, 3, 4, 5 players which whom they talk, they build up a good connection. And if the things are not very serious, we discuss how to manage, and they manage not to arrive at me. When things arrive to me, must be the maximum of a situation. So also from this point of view, from the calmness that one give, someone, everybody, we have different personalities, and we must be a complex group from this point of view of personality. One is more calm, one is to joke, one is to create atmosphere, one is very serious, one is very motivated inside of the training. Yeah? So I believe that you can understand very well.
So how would you describe yourself as a person, not as a coach?
As a person? But do you believe that can I describe myself? In this moment that I'm getting older, I know I start to be a little crazy. I don't know how. Finally, I don't know. You should tell, or people around me should analyze. What I feel that I start to be a little older, that I am getting older,
And this is the perfect pass to tell us another story about this little guy standing on your table.
Stadler. Hey, I go. This is your camera.
This is the microphone.
No, it's this is the microphone. Doesn't matter. You can record why is. We are all natural, not. This is Stadler. This is the present that. Guys, be natural. Don't make malakias. This is Stadler. Is the guy from Muppets show. There are two old guys in the balcony that never satisfied and all the time criticizing. And your friend, as my friend, Kirkir, made me this present when it was my birthday on 17th of February, telling me that this is the other half of me, because I start to be like him all the time, to criticize, but in a comic way and in a nice way. I know, and I do sometimes on purpose to create also a nice atmosphere and the people to laugh and to laugh with me. But I'm afraid that in 10 years I will not be so simpa as I am now from this point of view. Okay, somehow this is our story of this season. I can tell you that and I, because you asked me about responsibility, I love the city. My wife loves the atmosphere. Whenever she feels a little sad or with problems, she goes immediately out and without doing, just walking, and you feel the nice, the enthusiasm of being alive. But sometimes for me, this pressure made me to feel that I'm in one of the most beautiful place in the world, but somehow in a psychological prison, jail, because of all this pressure and this responsibility. I have a very, very nice relation, okay, totally different with boss. We are two different persons, and I have to tell you, because it's the reality, that he made me to be a better coach. Why? Because a lot of things. He pushed my limits. He made me to learn to manage huge pressure, but he was doing it on purpose. He made me to really to believe in impossible targets. And I told him this. When it was his birthday, I thanks for all of them, even if we had one moment when I left from here. Doesn't matter, we are today in a different kind of relations. Also, the talks that we have are totally different, and in moments when we are more calm, and even if we are on fire or under pressure or after a not good result, we analyze in a much positive, neutral way to understand exactly what we have to do. So this is my story of this season in Salonique. I told you everything.